For more about the situation on the ground in eastern Ukraine, we're joined now via Skype by James Jones, who is in Kharkov reporting for Frontline. Again, the Russians call it Kharkov, the Ukrainians call it Kharkiv. This is just an indicator of how tense the situation is on the ground. This was the second largest city. This is where Yanukovych ran to for support. What's happening on the ground as this vote's taking place in Crimea?
So here the situation is incredibly tense. And as a way of kind of showing their solidarity with Crimea and their own desire to perhaps gain independence and, you know, join Russia, they had this kind of unofficial and actually illegal referendum on the square here today. Seemed like about 10,000 people came and they were chanting Russia, Putin save us, slagging off the new government in Kiev, who they see as kind of fascists and, you know, thugs, effectively. And so then they had this big vote, which frankly is meaningless. It's not an official referendum. It has no consequences, but it's just a show of strength. And then just outside, about 200 meters from where I'm sitting now, they're currently trying to storm the government building. And it's very hard to tell what proportion of the population here support what they're doing, but certainly this minority is incredibly vocal, right, and sometimes incredibly violent.
All right, so this is a city where neighbor is fighting neighbor on this particular issue.
That's right. I mean, on the streets, there are constant arguments breaking out between people, some of whom know each other, but simply they're miles apart. You know, some of these people are desperate to become part of Russia. In fact, even going back to the Soviet Union, you know, there are hammers and sickles, you know, flags showing hammers and sickles on the square, enormous flags, people chanting about the Soviet Union. And this is a kind of weird time warp we're in here. And yet the other half of the city was incredibly supportive of the revolution in Kiev. So, you know, it feels very, very tense here. And, you know, on Friday night, a couple of people were killed,
yep,
by the Ukrainian nationalists. And that potentially is kind of provocation that gives Putin legitimate reasons, or at least a pretext, to send Russian troops in.
James Jones reporting from eastern Ukraine. Thanks so much.
Thanks for having me.